Today I'm going to make tahiri, which is yellow pulav rice. I am trying to make this for two people. I have soaked 1 cup of rice with some water. It's just about 10 minutes. I have cut some red onions. It's just, I think, half of red onions. We don't want too much of it. And deseeded like a few of green peas, not too many. I have taken some potatoes because they go really well with rice. So this is about 1.5 potato, or you could use 2 smaller versions. As you see, I have kept the peel on, just wash off excess mud from the peel, and this is really healthy. Some green chilies for taste, and I have also used carrots as well, add some taste to rice. I tend to cut them into semicircles or circles, but you could dice them. Try to make carrot as thinly diced as possible, because carrot takes some time to cook if it's not really fresh. For that matter, any root vegetable. And moving on, I have here 1 spoon of ginger garlic paste, not too much. I have half a spoon of coriander powder, a small pinch of turmeric, and salt as per taste. And for tempering, I'm going to use cumin seeds as well as mustard seeds. So yeah, about right. Now let me heat up some oil and get cooking. So the oil has heated up, and I have added all the cumin seeds and mustard seeds to crackle. I just need to give it a few seconds until they crackle. Yeah, you should hear this sound. And then I will go about and add red onions. I'm adding onions now, and we would need onions to turn brown and transparent. A little towards the brown side, so that it looks cooked and well done. And be careful, you don't want it to turn too brown, otherwise it starts leaking the brown color onto the pulao. Onions have turned brown and transparent, so just before they turn too brown, we have to add our coriander ginger garlic paste. So I have added a bit of water, let me show you, to this, so that it does not burn while adding and does not leave a very burnt and sad smell. So add a couple of drops of water, turn it into a paste, and add it into the onions. I have added the ginger garlic and coriander paste. It is a little noisy now because of the water content. You just need the rawness of the ginger and garlic to go away, and the very raw smell that comes along with ginger and garlic to get settled, and then we need to add all our vegetables along with green chilies into this. So now I have added the vegetables, and I'm going to just toss it a bit so that they are a little fried and not just boiled along with the pulao. So give it a few minutes, and now it's going to become a nice brownish color on the side of all these vegetables. Also, it will help carrots and green peas cook, which again take a lot of time. So you don't want the rice to be cooked and the vegetables to remain raw. So toss it a bit, give it a minute or two, and then you can add rice. So I have now added a little water to the cooking vegetables. And now when the water bubbles up like this, you need to add rice. We need to go ahead and cook and make water hot like this before we add rice, so that any ghee or oil that you have added to your rice is evenly spread, and even it helps rice cook faster. Added the rice, and I'm just going to now pressure cook this until I hear 2 or at least 3 whistles. See, the steaming hot pulao is ready to serve.